Good morning, my beautiful students. How are you today? I hope that you are pretty fine. Well, let's start with the class for today. And we are going to be having a general review of different tenses. We are going to finish with the different tenses that we have. And after that, we are going to continue with more topics that are going to be having a higher level. Obviously an intermediate level, don't worry. But as I was telling you before, it is pretty important for you that you have this kind of review for all the doubts that maybe you could have, no? So welcome to your week number 3 or third week, and let's start with our topics. Let me tell you something. During the class, we are going to be having, hello, one morning, one more time. During our class or Zoom class, we are going to be having different activities in order to practice our speaking skills, listening, reading and writing, and so on. Don't worry, wait for them. But in this moment, let me show you some things that maybe we are going to be working with. So are you ready? I hope that you are ready. Let's start with this. So, general review and general tenses. I didn't change my background because as we are talking about the same topics that I was waiting to show you the last week, well, I said, oh my goodness, this is going to be the first one. So here we go. So, if you have any doubts with platforms, with homeworks and so on, please, please, please let me know and I'm going to be helping you. Now, we are going to be having a speaking time during our class, but today I'm in a hurry because I don't really want to show you different things that I have here for you. So let's get the party started with all the topics that I have here. We are going to be having about different topics that I have for you. These activities, we are going to be having them during the classes. And I remember that we, stop here. I remember that we were talking about these object pronouns, and that was great. I think that we already know how to use the object pronouns. No, he calls me, I like you. We were having some activities related to this. Also possessive adjectives, no? My cat, your favorite food, his, all these effectuations, subject, and positive pronouns. I remember that also we were talking about possessive adjectives, and we were talking about the difference between both, right? I was giving you some examples about this is my laptop, it's mine, the glasses are mine and not yours, this is my brother's book, it's his, right? Please let me know if you have some questions about this. Remember, we need to be practicing in order that we can be learning by heart all these topics. Also, I remember that we were talking about, well, these are all that we were talking. Subject pronouns, object pronouns, possessive adjectives, and possessive pronouns. We were talking about the differences, talking that we are going to be using possessive pronouns in order to avoid repeating a kind of information, no? Also, we were talking about reflexive pronouns, myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourself, and ourselves, right? We were talking about that we have reflexive pronouns in order to talk about the same subject in the sentence, no? I was doing my homework by myself. Nobody was helping me. I was doing it by myself. Oh, my brother was, cleaning his house by himself. Ah, that's how we were using this kind of pronouns. No, we were having different examples with this, and also we were having some exercises. I remember that we were having this. Hey. So we were working with this grammar quiz, and now I'm going to start with this with this topic, that it is going to be about demonstrative pronouns. Do you remember that we were talking about this and these, the pronunciation, those and that? We were having these examples that this is going to be for singular here near for me, and that is going to be only for one thing, but far for me. And these, the pronunciation is going to be for different things that I have here near for me, and those are going to be for those things. That is going to be for plurals, for different things that I have, but far from me. That's how we are going to be using and working with these pronouns, no? I was giving you the definition that we are going to be using these pronouns in order to show or identify one or a specific number of nouns or things that are far or near from us. That's how we are going to be working with this. This apple, that I have here next to me, maybe that apple that is in front of me, that in front of me, these five apples that I have here that I'm going to be eating, or those apples that I have in front of my face but far from me, those are going to be the apples, and those is going to be the word that I'm going to be working with. We were having also this exercise, and we were talking about this pen is red, these pens are red, no? Singulars and plurals, near some far. That is the most important thing that we need to be learning. This, that is near, these, that are near, that is far, only one, those, that is far, two or more. That is how we are going to be using them. This and that, the exercise, what are these, what are those? I was showing you that we can be answering with they are balloons and that. Okay. And also I remember that we were talking about the interrogative pronouns, which, what, whom, whoever, right? Which one would you like? Which doctor did you see? No? ¿A cuál? De todos, ¿a cuál elegiste? No, que a doctor Pérez. Ay, excelente. De todos, del doctor López, del doctor Montes, del doctor Trujillo. Yo elegí al doctor Pérez. Okay, that's who. Whom did you tell this about? No, we were talking about how to, about some different example. Who told you? Oh, John told me. ¿Quién, no? Whom did you tell? I told Mary. ¿A quién le dijiste? Le dije, Mary, what happened? An accident happened. ¿Qué pasó? What do you want? I want a coffee. ¿Qué quieres? Quiero un café. Which came first? The Porsche 911. ¿Cuál vino primero? Which will the doctor see first? The doctor will see the patient in blue first. There's one car missing. Whose hasn't arrived? ¿No? ¿Quién, a quién, qué o cuál, de muchísimos, which, cuál, de dos, tres específicos? Ay, me quedé de a seis pensando, híjole, de inglés o en español. ¿No? El which, acuérdense que es para seleccionar entre un número específico de objetos, de cosas y situaciones. El what es qué, general, o cuál, pero de muchísimas opciones, ¿no? Who, quién, a whom, a quién, ¿no? Who's, de quién. And here you have the different interrogative pronouns. Who, whom, which, whose, de quién, where, dónde, when, cuándo, why, por qué, What, qué, cuáles de muchos y how, no, cómo, de manera. We were talking about some examples about who and whom, which and whose, what. And we were talking about some different examples. Who won the game yesterday? To whom did you give the book? ¿Quién ganó el juego ayer? ¿A quién le diste el book? No, el book, el libro. Whose? You are going to be using who and whom for persons. Whose? You are going to be using also for persons, but in order to show possession. That is going to be the difference between who and whom. No, and whose is going to be for possession. Who and whom es para de quien le recae la acción. ¿No? ¿Quién en general? ¿A quién? Who, de quién. Una pequeña palabrita nos va a estar cambiando ahí la situación. Whose car was parked there just now? ¿De quién es el carro que está aparcado, que está estacionado aquí ahora? No, whose mother works as a nurse in the hospital? ¿La mamá de quién trabaja como enfermera en el hospital? What? It is going to be used for animals and things. For example, what animal has horns? ¿Qué animal tiene cuernos? Pero de todos los animales que tenemos en el mundo, ¿cuál tiene cuernos? Si yo te dijera, which animal has horns? ¿Qué animal tiene cuernos? Pero yo te estaría mostrando dos o tres o cuatro opciones, ¿no? Para que tú pudieras elegir de estos, este es el que tiene cuernos. Esa es la diferencia entre what and which. What is the color of the hair of her hair? ¿Cuál es el color de su cabello? Yo automáticamente al tener al hair sé que estoy hablando de una mujer, ¿no? Pues puede ser no sé, rojo, amarillo, morado, se lo pintó, rubio, con luces, etc. Si yo te dijera, which is the color that she has? Brown or brown chocolate? ¿Cuál es el color que ella tiene en su cabello? ¿Café o café chocolate? ¿No? ¿Ves? Te estoy dando dos opciones específicas. What es para opciones diversas. Which is going to be used for persons, animals, and things. And as I was telling you, it is when you are going to be selecting for some specific situations, which book took my book just now? No, which boy took my book just now? Which Carlos, Peter, or Alejandro took my book? Which cat stole the fish from the basket? The black one, the white black. The black what? The one, the white one, or the brown white? No, the brown one. Ah, okay. Which is the biggest building in this area? Oh, that tower is the biggest. Ah, I am being very specific. That's how we are going to be working with this. Very well. Great job. Excellent, excellent. Those were the possessive pronouns. Oh my goodness, I believe that you are an expert with all the pronouns that we are going to be having in the life. Obviously, we are going to be having more, okay? But at least the most important are now in your mind. Remember, we need to be practicing. Well, now that we finished with this, finally, we are going to be practicing, but the practice I'm going to be sending you in your platform, and also we are going to be reviewing. Okay, but now let's start with the review for present simple in affirmative, negative, and interrogative. Teacher, I already know that. Okay. I'm pretty happy for that, really, 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 because that means that we can continue with different topics. But maybe you have some doubts. No, that's the reason why we are going to be talking about this. This is going to be pretty fast. Don't worry, okay? In this class, you are going to be having, I hope, at least all the review of the basic tenses. So don't worry. So, okay, now let's start with something that is going to be maybe new for you. It's a joke, I know that you know it. Just kidding, sorry. The verb to be. Let me tell you that the verb to be is going to be like the Chinese. the little Chinese. It is going to be everywhere. In every place that you turn your face, you are going to be finding verb to be, okay? And at the end of this class, I'm going to let you know why. So, verb to be. You already know that the verb to be means two things. Cero estar, no? It's my combo, my Cinepolis combi. What do you want? I want nachos and I want a hot dog. No, would you prefer better a combo with nachos, hot dogs, and popcorns? Yes! Oh, it is going to be my verb. It's going to be my combo. Cero estar. But remember that it is going to be like a rebel verb, okay? Because it doesn't matter a lot that we are going to be having two verbs in just one word. The way that the verb to be is going to be handled is going to be a kind of specific, because before the verb to be, you cannot write anything. After the verb to be, you can be writing everything that you want, okay? So remember the verb to be. M is R. We are not going to be pronouncing M is R. No, no, no. M is R. M is R. That is going to be the pronunciation. M is R. So, as you already know the personal pronouns, we are going to conjugate this. What is that conjugation? When you are saying, you are going to conjugate in a verb when you are using or making use of a pronoun or a person or a subject, and then a verb. I am, you are, she is, he is, it is, they are, we are, yo soy, yo estoy, tú eres o tú estás, ella es o ella está, él es o él está. Eso, el animal, el clima, whatever you want, eso está. We are, nosotros somos nosotros, nosotros o nosotras somos o nosotras estamos. They are, ellos o ellas son o están. Yes, teacher, but how am I going to know when my verb is going to be meaning ser or when my verb is going to be meaning start? ¿Cómo voy a saber, mis, bella mis, cuándo mi verbo va a significar ser o estar? Ah, bueno, te cuento, dependiendo de tu contexto. Depending the context that you have, it is going to be the meaning that you are going to be giving to your verb, okay? Si yo digo, I am in my living room sleeping, uy, sala durmiendo, no puede ser yo soy en mi sala durmiendo. A fuercitas tendría que ser, yo estoy en mi sala durmiendo. Si yo te digo, I am an English teacher, no podría significar yo estoy una maestra de inglés, sino que sería yo soy una maestra de inglés. Entonces, dependiendo de tu contexto, es como tú vas a conocer o darle el significado de ser o estar. Super easy. So, yes, please say yes. I don't like to explain these topics like affirmative, negative, interrogative. It's like so boring, maybe. That's the reason why I used to say that. Okay, we are going to be saying yes, we are going to be saying no, and we are going to be asking. That's it, okay? And it is going to be pretty easy. I know that you know it because I am, he, she, it, is, you, we, they, are. I don't understand, teacher. I don't know where I am going to be using these or how. Well, let me give you a clue. This is going to be super easy. It is going to be like a fast clue. Te doy una super pista de cómo conjugar. Siempre el pronombre chiquitito se va con este chiquito. Son primos, así. Se adoran siempre juntos. Los mejores amigos de la vida. He, she, it. Los solitarios, terceras, por así decirlo, se les conoce como tercera persona. Pero todo el muchacho, la muchacha, el perrito, el gato, Doña Lupe, mi primo, mi cuñado, mi compadre, mi vecina, el clima, whatever. It is going to be with is. Sujetos chicos, verbos chicos. But when you have the biggest one, you are going to be using this biggest one with the biggest verb. Okay. Chiqui, ¿cómo decirlo? El especial de la familia, así el de se va con el verbo especialito. Luego, ya de ahí, otros solitarios y chiquitos, una sola personita, como es una sola persona, se va con el verbo que le cabe a una sola persona. Los que son muchísimos se van con el verbo que le caben muchísimas personas. That is going to be the difference. How you are going to be using this? Es que no me acordaba si era she, are. No, porque she solamente es una persona, entonces se tiene que ir con un verbo adecuado. Ah, no, es como cuando vas al súper, no llevas tu gran carrito del súper para comprar solamente un pan bimbo y un litro de leche, agarras tu canastilla, ¿no? O generalmente, no juzgo. Agarras generalmente una canastilla y pues eso echas poquito porque pues vas a llevar poquito. No es que voy a comprar la despensa de toda la semana. Ah, bueno, agárrate el carrito de súper grandote porque le vas a meter mucho. Es lo mismo con estos pronombres, ¿sale? Tienes mucha gente, vete con el verbo que le cabe mucho. That is going to be. What examples can you give me with this? For example, I am in my house. You are my best friend. They are in the park. We are in Canada. Those are examples of this. What other examples can you give me? Tell me. With M is R. You can do it, you can do it, you can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Okay, that's excellent. You can be writing on your notebook, okay? As we are doing these exercises, you can be remembering. Ah, okay. So you are going to be reminded to do this. So I'm going to be writing some questions, sentences also on. Try to do the exercise in your notebook. It's okay. Well, now, this is going to be super easy. Let me write you an example, okay? As we already know, we are going to be having, for example, this. You are my best friend. Oh, my sister is beautiful. My friends and I are in the park. We are saying that, yes. Because if I ask you, are we saying yes, no, or what? No, aquí estás diciendo que sí, simplemente porque no tienes ningún no. Si no tienes ningún no o un signo de interrogación, pues estás diciendo que sí. Esas son las famosas oraciones afirmativas, donde que estás afirmando, o sea, diciendo que sí. Como te dije, no me encanta manejarlo como afirmaciones, negaciones. No, lenguaje coloquial. Sí, no, pregunto, ¿no? Y aquí, si no estoy poniendo ninguno, pues significa que estoy diciendo que sí. No, por así decirlo, en su estado natural. These are going to be some examples. Y tu oración puede ser tan larga como tú quieras. De hecho, aquí le puedes aumentar. You are my best friend because I know you since we were young. Tú eres mi mejor amigo o amiga porque te conozco desde que éramos jóvenes, ¿no? Y toda esa oración, yes, and you are saying that, yes, and you are using your verb to be, ¿sale? Pero ahí tengo más verbos y en pasado y en todo, sí. Pero la esencia de mi oración está en presente, con mi verbo to be, aunque aquí estuviera en futuro y pasado y todo eso. Depende, vamos a aprender a leer contextos específicos para que tú sepas distinguir si es afirmación o negación, aunque tengas una oración compuesta o un texto o un contexto compuesto de diferentes tiempos gramaticales. That is the affirmative way. Now, here's to the power of no. What is this? Ah, let me tell you that now we are going to be saying that. No. And for that reason, let me show you that we are going to be different ways to say no. Okay. The negative, negative form. Okay, more names like this. You are going to be saying like no, saying no, only adding no. You want to say that no? Add the word not, and that's it. Okay, ¿quieres decir que no? Ponle que no. Y listo, ¿quieres decir que sí? Quítale el no entonces. Quiero decir que no otra vez, ponle el no. No, es que ya quiero decir que sí, pues quítale no. That is the only thing that you need to be doing en todos los tipos gramaticales. ¿Quieres decir que no? Ponle el no. ¿Quieres decir que sí? Quítale el no. Sale o no le pongas no. Pero solamente tienes que saber dónde va a ir ese no. Como te dije al principio, este verbo es muy especial, es un verbo rebelde. Antes del verbo to be no hay nada, después del verbo to be lo que tú quieras. ¿Sale? Por eso te digo aquí, después del verbo to be, ponle no. Si tú quisieras decir am, I not am, mira hasta la cara que hice. No se puede, no puedes. You cannot. Super regla. Este verbo es tipo super bad. No permite así, no hay uno más poderoso que él. Hay verbos similares, el have, ¿cuál otro? Los verbos modales, pero este es el rey por excelencia, por así decirlo, ¿no? No comprendo por qué se llevan a veces una semana o dos enseñando el verbo to be, si es bien fácil. Para usted, ¿ves? Que ya lo... No, porque, mira, ya viste, ¿no? ¿Cómo decir, cómo afirmar? Vamos a decir que no. I am not, yo no estoy, o yo no soy. I'm not happy today because it is not raining. No estoy feliz hoy porque no está lloviendo. No soy feliz hoy porque no está lloviendo y yo amo la lluvia. Example, ¿no? I am not in my house in this moment. Sorry, call me later. No estoy en mi casa en este momento, por favor. Llámame luego. Bueno. You are going to be having two ways to say, another two ways to say that, no, that they are going to be the famous contractions. Contracciones. Pero no contracciones, es como, ¿se está contrayendo? Sí, se está empequeñeciendo, por así decirlo, ¿no? Se está haciendo más pequeño. Entonces, de esta manera, vamos a hacerlo también aquí. El inglés es bien padre porque puedes hacerlo más chiquito, ¿no? Y sigue sonando bien, pero te cuento, contracciones es para que tú suenes más informal. Completo, I am not, you are not my sister, my brother is not in the house in this moment. It sounds normal. If you want to sound more informal, well, you are going to be making use of the contractions, okay? And you are going to be having two kind of contractions. But my question is, which one, form one or form two, is the correct one? Cuéntame, ¿cuál es la correcta? Well, actually, both are going to be correct. Porque he visto, no, es que yo digo, you're not, y ahora vi, he isn't. ¿Es correcto juntar el verbo con la negación? Sí, ¿por qué no? O por el contrario, yo siempre digo he isn't, pero la otra vez vi que pusieron he's not. ¿Es correcto? Sí. There's no problem, really. Actually, this is easy. It's like the mathematics. Es como las matemáticas, como las tablas. 2 por 4, 8. 4 por 2, 8. It is going to be almost the same. El resultado es el mismo. El significado es el mismo. Solamente cambió la forma en que puse primero 2 por 4 y después 4 por 2. Pero es exactamente lo mismo. Igual en el inglés. Sale. Hay ciertas reglas gramaticales que sí tienes que seguir porque no, como te decía, no vayas a poner el not, ¿no? Antes del verbo to be. Ahí sí no. Gramaticalmente no es correcto. Es como si yo dijera, yo estoy no. Dice, sí te entiendo. No, y ok, te entiendo, te sigo la corriente, sé lo que me quisiste dar a entender, pero así no se dice, no, es correcto, así no se va a decir, no es correcto. No, ¿por qué? Porque hay ciertas cuestiones ya establecidas en el idioma donde marca, ¿no? La colocación de ciertas cosas, pero en contracciones y cuestiones específicas, no hay problema, it is going to be the same, ¿no? So, you can say, I'm not happy. or I am not happy. You cannot say, for example, am not, I am not. No, that is not going to be correct. In this case, you can join together only your subject with your verb, and that's it. You cannot join this together. Esos dos no se juntan, solamente el I am. But after that, with you are not, you can say you're not. I mean, you can be joining you and are, or you can say you aren't. You can be joining the are with the not. And it is going to be the same. You're not my best friend. You aren't my best friend. It is the same. He's not, or he isn't. It is exactly the same. You can be joining the subject with the verb, or you can be joining the verb with the not. And it is going to be the same. Puedo decir, Alex, not in the house. Yes, you can do it. Alex is not in the house. Yes, you can do it. There is no situation for that. There is a not a negative situation for that. For example, Alejandro's not in the house. Yes. This is your negative, your verb to be. Oh, can I say Alejandro is not in the house? Can I write also, let's say, yes, but always with capital letters. Alejandro's not in the house. Alejandro is not in the house. Alejandro isn't in the house. Is that correct? Yes, it is correct. Can I say instead of Alejandro, he isn't in the house? Yes, it is correct. Can I say he's not in the house? Yes, all those possibilities are for you. Todas esas posibilidades son para ti. Mientras no te comas el verbo to be, mientras no digas Alejandro not in the house o he not in the house, todo está bien. Siempre debes de tener todo completo, aunque sea aplastado ahí, juntado, as you want, but you need to have that, okay? So, she's not, she isn't, it's not, it isn't, we're not, we aren't, you're not, you aren't, they're not, they aren't, my friends are not, my friends aren't. Yes, it is correct. You can be using the form one or the form two. Don't try to remember what is the form one, what is the form two. No. Understand it in your mind, understand it in your heart that you can be matching, you can be joining. Okay, all these words. No quiero que te aprendas el forma uno era así, forma dos era así. No. Yo quiero que lo comprendas de corazón, en tu mente. Que, el simple hecho de que puedo dejarlo normal, que es más formal, puedo unirlo de una forma, puedo unirlo de la otra. Es como si me dices, Miss, te invito a comer. ¿Quieres pizza? Voy contigo. Es esta forma. ¿Quieres pizza? Voy contigo. Sí, me voy a comer contigo de un lado. Y luego me llaman los otros cuates, ¿no? O amigos, oye, amiga, ¿quieres, no sé, pizza, hamburguesa? Sí, y también me voy con ellos. Tanto me puedo ir a comer pizza como me puedo ir a comer hamburguesas. Es lo mismo aquí, como te juntas con uno, como que juntas el otro. And it is going to be the same. Y por el simple hecho de tener un not, obviamente se vuelve negación o me estás diciendo que no. Que yo quiero decir que sí, quítale no. Quiero poder decir que no, ponle no. That is how we are going to be working with the verb to be. Así es como vamos a trabajar con el verbo to be. ¿Sale? Ah, mira, ya te di tus ejemplos. Alejandro's not in the house. He's not in the house. Alejandro isn't in the house. Alejandro is not in the house. He's not in the house. He isn't in the house. Different examples. It is going to be, I cannot see a big deal with this topic? No. Now, let me erase all these things that I have here for you. Clear my troubles. Yes. Now, my beautiful ones, questions. Questions are my favorite. Yes, questions are my favorite because you are going to be getting a lot of information from people, from situations, and so on. And this is going to be amazing because look at this. How I am going to be forming my questions. Y déjame te digo que estos tips que te estoy dando y este repaso te sirven para todo lo demás que vamos a estar viendo, ¿ok? Interrogative form. So, let me tell you that in Spanish, we are going to be having two interrogative marks. In Spanish. In English, we are not going to be having two. We are going to be having only one question mark. No, it is not the number two. No, es mi número dos. Es una marca de pregunta, un signo de interrogación. In English, we are going to be having only one question mark. But at the beginning, what am I going to be doing? Oye, entra a mi casa, porfa, sírvete agua y vuelves a salir. Ajá, gracias, Angie, pero como primeramente para cerrar tengo que entrar, ¿no? No puedo cerrar si no estoy adentro. ¿Cómo le hago? En el inglés siempre va a ser lo mismo. Aunque en el español tenemos dos signos y en el inglés uno, en el inglés no vamos a usar una marca, sino un auxiliar o un verbo. Un auxiliar va a ser una palabrita que te va a estar ayudando en algunas dificultades. Y en este caso, mi dificultad es que, ¿cómo le voy a hacer para entrar? Si yo te digo, porfa, 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 se quedaron adentro, se quedó adentro mi bolsa, ¿me la puedes traer? Ajá, ok, ya estoy afuera de tu casa, tu bolsa está adentro, ¿cómo entro? No, para que pueda yo agarrar tu bolsa y salir, me abres, tienes que abrir a fuerzas, agarras la bolsa y te sales, ya saliste, aquí está mi bolsa, tienes que agarrarla. ¿Cómo le hago para entrar? Agárrate tu verbo. Aquí el verbo to be no necesita ayuda, él se vale solo, por eso te decía, es el verbo rebelde, él se manda solo, antes de él, nada, después de él, lo que quieras. For that reason, your verb to be is going to be at the beginning. Am I your friend? Soy tu amiga. Am I your daughter? Soy tu hija. Yes, you are my daughter. Oh my goodness. Are you sad? ¿Estás triste? Yes, I am. Is he your boyfriend? Yes, he is. Are they coming to the class? Yes, they are. That is how we are going to be making use of the verb to be. Okay, remember at the beginning, if you want to ask something, verb to be at the beginning, then your subject, all the things that you want to be talking about, and your question mark, no? Here you have different examples. I am not in the kitchen. I am not a nurse. Am I a nurse? I'm a lady. Am I a nurse? Is he my father? Saying that no, asking a question. I am in the kitchen, saying that not. I am not in the kitchen. I am in the kitchen. I'm not in the kitchen. Am I in the kitchen? That is how we are going to be working and playing with this. But when you are going to be asking, you are going to be having different kind of answers. For example, the short answers, the super, super short answers, and the long answers, no? Obviously, long answers are going to be more formal, okay? Short answers are going to be very specific and maybe a kind of informal, okay? Am I waiting for her? Yes, I am. Or if somebody's asking me, am I asking for this? Somebody can answer, yes, you are. Ay, thank you. No. Are you happy? Yes, I am. No, I'm not. No, I'm not happy. I'm sad. Those are answers. Is she your sister? Yes, she is. No, she is not. No, she isn't. No, she is not my sister. No, she is not my sister. She is my cousin. Oh, can you see? You're going to be having different kind of answers. Ya viste, puedes tener diferentes tipos de respuestas, desde la más cortita hasta la más larga. Yes, she is. No, she isn't. No, she's not. No, she's not my friend. She's my enemy because I hate her because... Ta, ta, ta. ¿No? Mal ejemplo. Ejemplo cruel. Some examples of these kind of answers. Here we have it. Are you sad? Answer. Yes, I am. Sí estoy. No, I am not. Oh, no. I'm not. No. No. I'm happy. Oh, no, I am not sad. I am pretty happy. No, I am, no, I'm not. I'm pretty happy because I was eating a chocolate. Ta, 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 ta. Can you see the infinity that you have in order to answer? Long answers, short answers, medium answer. Are you sad? Yes. No. Or what? What do you think? Well, all those are answers. Si te das cuenta, todas esas son respuestas, más formales, más informales, indirectas, directas. Are you sad? What do you think? ¿Estás triste? ¿Qué piensas? ¿Tú qué piensas? No, that is how you can be answering with the verb to be and with the different tenses, okay? To the different questions, we are going to be making use of these different answers. It depends on you. Okay, it depends on you, depending how you want to answer, but it is important that at least you know how to use the questions and the answers, sentences that are saying that yes, the sentences that are saying that no, how can you be using them? How you can be playing with them? That is going to be pretty different. Okay. And in few words, here you have the verb to be. Saying that yes, saying no, asking. I am, she is, we are not, they are not, are we, are, is he, is it, and crocodile. No, it is not a crocodile, it is an alligator. Different. Okay, that's the verb to be. That's the verb to be. And you are going to be practicing in this moment with some sentences. What are you going to do? You are going to write two sentences, saying yes, saying no, asking and answering, okay? It is going to be one of the exercises that we are going to be using in order to practice this. Try to do this in at least less than 5 minutes. You can do it. Ready? Ready, ready? Okay, if you are ready, let's continue. Remember that a contraction is when you make shorter your sentence. You can be using the contraction in negative or in affirmative, okay? I'm not, am. You are not, you aren't, you're not. But also when you are saying that, yes, he's, she's, it's, we're, they're, it's exactly the same. All in questions, it is not pretty common to see some contractions, but at you indeed you can use it, okay? Are you, aren't you? Is she, isn't she? We are not going to be using contractions in the questions. Some maybe in when we are saying that, no, aren't they? Oh, there is when you are going to be making some contractions in questions, okay? Some more examples that you can give me, some more examples that you have. Okay, understand you do not ask questions, you should. If you have questions about this topic, please, please, please let me know and I'm going to be helping you. Okay, enough. If we are ready with the verb to be, let me tell you that maybe we are going to be working with this Google document, and also you can be having different kind of exercises that I'm going to be giving to you in order that you can be practicing if you want, okay? Because now we are going to start with the simple present. Acuérdate lo que te dije, ¿quieres hacer preguntas negativas? Se puede. Pero generalmente no vamos a usar muchas contracciones con el I am, por ejemplo. I'm not you. I'm not she. Isn't she? Aren't they? Ahí sí queda. O are not they? Ok. O are they not? Vamos a tener una parte especial para preguntas negativas en todos los tiempos, ¿sale? Porque luego están con ese pendiente, ¿cómo se hace una oración negativa, Miss? Es lo mismo. It is exactly the same. Really, it is exactly the same. So, don't worry. So, I think that we have a little time for another topic, okay? And let's start with this present simple, present simple, What is going to be the present simple? Well, before to start with the present simple, oh, simple present, let me tell you that you are going to be having this list that it is going to be about the 200 most common verbs that you can find in English. 200 most common verbs that we are going to be having. You can be reviewing them. You already have a list on your platform where you are having all these verbs and more in English, in Spanish, with pronunciation in order that you can be learning them. Miss, how can I be learning all these verbs? Well, let me tell you that there are going to be different tips that you can use a lot. But my first tip, I'm going to be recording you a video related to these tips. Remember, okay, verbs are everywhere, are super important, because you are going to be using them or making use of them. When you are talking, verbs, you need to know verb. And we have open identity, feel, find, produce, reveal, set, write, wonder, and so on. All those are going to be verbs. What? 200 verbs? Well, actually not 200 verbs, at least 200 verbs, por lo menos 200 verbos, los 200 más usuales. Pero tú necesitas muchos más, muchos más, los verbos. Really, really? Yes. Yes, guys. Verbs are very, very, very important. You are going to be having verbs everywhere, okay? Verbs everywhere. That's the reason why you need to know verbs. Well, present simple, what is that, Miss? Well, you are going to be having the definition here, no? The simple present, also called present simple or present indefinite, okay? It is used to show, well, you can be reading the definition, okay? But in few words, I'm going to let you know what the present simple is and where we are going to be using it. This is when you are going to be talking about scheduled actions, okay? When you are going to be doing something by repetition, like a habit, like a generalization, okay? For that, the present simple is going to be used, okay? Sometimes you are going to be using these tense in order to talk about future. It doesn't matter that it is in present, okay? In present. And sometimes you are going to be using it for actions that are happening in the very moment. But the most important thing that you need to remember is that the present simple is for scheduled actions, for routines, for habits, for generalizations, okay? For example, I speak English. It's something general. It's something that I can do every day, no? Maybe it is not a schedule like at 5 p.m., but it is a habit. A habit, it is a generalization, okay? It is something general, something that I used to do. In the present, like a routine, like a habit, okay? But look at this. What questions do I have here? What situations do I have here? You speak English, you do not speak English. Do you speak English? And we have for the other side, he speaks English. He does not speak English. Does he speak English? What is the difference? Why do we have different things here? Sorry, why do I have the letter S? Why do I have that word does? What is that word does? And what do I have do? Let me explain you something. Did you see something strange? Yes, I know. Those were the questions that I was asking you. Here we go. In English, in present, we are going to be having it, did, or personal pronouns, object pronouns, and so on pronouns, okay? But the verb is going to be one of the most important situations that we are going to be facing. Okay. Read. Why we are going to be having this situation. Okay. Let me tell you something. Remember, when we are going to be talking about he, she, it, not only as a subject pronoun, okay? With my neighbor, my dog, my friends, my school, my parents, my mother, my father, my siblings, my brother, my sister, the person that is in front of my house, knocking the door in this moment. Well, when you are going to be talking about he, she, or it, in any case, always to the verb, you are going to be adding the letter S. Miss, what's the meaning of the letter S? Now, actually, it is not going to be having like a specific meaning, okay? It is like a rule that we are going to be having in English in order to conjugate the verbs. The most important thing here in this tense is that for he, she, it, and all the people or things related to these personal pronouns in present. When you are saying that yes, you are going to be adding a letter S. Okay, only for he, she, it. Always you are going to be having a letter S. It doesn't matter that it doesn't mean anything, but it is going to be making a big difference with the verbs, okay? And be careful because this is the first part only. Then you complement is going to be all the information, the extra information that you are going to be giving related to the thing that you want to explain. What do you think about this in this moment? Remember, you need to have a subject, your verb if you are, be careful if you are going to be adding an S, and your complement is all the extra information that you are going to be giving, okay? That is going to be. ¿Pero qué crees? Te voy a dejar un poquito picada de esto. ¡Qué barbaridad! Pero mira, es bueno que repasemos rápidamente estos tiempos gramaticales porque de aquí se van a derivar muchísimas cuestiones. Estamos cerca. Los más pesados son el verbo to be y el presente simple. Ya los demás es así como que como hilo de media, literalmente. Te vas corriendo, súper fácil. Déjame saber tus impresiones sobre la clase de hoy. ¿Fui lo específicamente clara? ¿Necesitas más ejemplos? ¿Alguna otra cuestión? Sabes que estoy para servirte, para apoyarte. Y que si necesitas algo, por favor, no dudes en comunicarte conmigo en la plataforma para que podamos saber dónde te reforzamos, dónde estamos siendo repetitivos, dónde no me di a entender, dónde tuviste situaciones para comprenderle y trabajaremos con ello. Pero ya. Ya, yo creo que ya te fastidié que sí, mis, ya. Te voy a dejar descansar un rato, solo por hoy, porque mañana seguimos, ¿ok? You are super special for me. Thank you for being with us today. Ya sé. Ay, mis, hoy estuvo medio tediosa la clase. Perdóname, ya quiero terminar con estos temas, pero por eso quería mostrarte. Urgente que termines de repasar estos temas para que ya seamos felices. Así nos paramos a ver las flores, nos tomamos un coffee, whatever you want, but it is important that we know all this, ¿ok? So, enjoy your day. See you tomorrow. Wonderful, wonderful day. Bye.